While I am generally a positivist when it comes to the human race, I think we can do great things as a species if we simply play our cards right, and I even think it's likely that we will, but I would be remiss not to also accept that we may not and could easily go extinct. This could happen in a number of ways, some of which we could make happen, but there's also the possibility of a natural extinction, such as if an asteroid hits us. But what of other civilizations in the universe? Surely they too face extinction, at least at some point in their development. Do some civilizations in our universe die? While it's not a great indicator of what aliens may or may not do, until we see another civilization, our own behavior is all we have to go on. In the case of extinction, this could go either way. We are clearly not extinct, so that could say that aliens destroying themselves is a rare occurrence. But we also know that we could go extinct, which in turn could say that many, maybe even a majority, of alien civilizations blow themselves up. That won't be an easy question to answer, since not only does it require us to detect one alien civilization, something that eludes us right now, but many until we have enough of a sampling to know. And I, personally, would find it bittersweet if the first civilization we detect is a dead one. But even dead civilizations leave traces and answer the great "are we alone" question. As a result, we should be on the lookout for them. In a paper by Adam Stevens, Duncan Forgan, and Jack O'Malley James, link below, they lay out just what signatures we could look for regarding destroyed civilizations. The first possibility is a long shot and highly unlikely to ever be detected due to the short period it would be visible. One of the major biosignatures we will look for when searching for life on other worlds will be the gases present in the atmosphere of the exoplanet. But if everything on that planet suddenly died, say it happened here on Earth, depending on how the destruction occurred, if it included all complex life or just the civilization, for about a year or so, the massive amounts of decomposition would release methane and ethane and be detectable at a distance to anyone that happens to be looking. Lasting a little longer, but also very unlikely to detect, are the effects of nuclear weapons. A large-scale nuclear war would, at least for several years, have telltale effects on an atmosphere, including airglow caused by fallout. This would essentially amount to observing a nuclear winter on a planet, but there would also be dust, so these indicators may not be so visible. But if you saw a planet that appeared to have life all of a sudden go dusty, it could mean that they blew themselves up. But they also might have been hit with an asteroid, so I doubt this sort of detection would be conclusive even if we did see it. What would be a dead ringer for a civilization is if you saw the war in progress. Nuclear detonations produce a distinctive and very artificial looking double flash of gamma rays. In fact, one of the early but now discounted ideas for explaining gamma ray bursts was alien nuclear testing. The ability to detect nuclear detonations at a distance, though, depends on the scale of the war. But if we on Earth blew ourselves up, it wouldn't be visible very far. But if the aliens are seriously armed to the teeth with very large weapons, it remains a possibility. As an aside, if we did by chance detect nuclear detonations, call it nuke SETI, it doesn't necessarily mean a nuclear war is in progress. If you saw regular, repeating detonations, for example, it could indicate a nuclear bomb-powered spacecraft. Such an idea exists for a sublight but very fast spacecraft design that literally propels itself through space by dropping nukes out the back. Also possible are the use of nukes for mining asteroids, or deflecting them, or anything else one might need a large detonation for. So detecting double flash detonations in space might not be that unlikely. Other possibilities that might be detectable are based on far future potential technologies such as molecular nanotechnology. The idea is that you can create a self-replicating nanobot that could consume an entire planet while making copies of itself exponentially. This is called the gray goo, and the end result of this would presumably look very artificial. However, as with all far future technologies, the real-world workings of such a weapon might not be as good as they sound on paper. The reason for this is that a gray goo weapon can be countered by another set of nanobots intended to take out the gray goo bots and thus preventing the destruction of the planet. And unless the war is interplanetary, there probably are going to be far more precise ways to weaponize nanotechnology that would preclude the need for a gray goo weapon. Other possibilities the authors mention include detecting an exoplanet with so much artificial pollution in its atmosphere that the civilization that put it there could not possibly have survived it. Or another one would be if we saw a planetary debris disk that contained artificial components, though the likelihood of being able to do that is almost nil given that most of the material would be natural and from the planet itself. Lastly, being a science fiction author, as I was researching this subject, I remembered old ideas from sci-fi that I found rather chilling. Think something like the Borg. There is one other type of evidence, if that's what you want to call it, that could indicate a dead civilization not included in the paper. If we find a machine civilization in our search of the galaxy with no corresponding biological component, there are only a few realistic possibilities for how that came to be. Either the original biological aliens became the machines, or the machines survived an annihilation war between biologicals, or the machines themselves destroyed the former biological civilization. That might make a machine intelligence detection in the universe a necromarker in and of itself. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently eyeing my new smart TV suspiciously. It's up to something, or maybe I just still don't know how to work it. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.